My name is Arash Khosravifar. I'm an assistant professor in the Civil and Environmental Engineering Department at PSU. Our focus in the geotechnical engineering program here is on earthquake-induced soil liquefaction. Soil liquefaction is an interesting but also devastating phenomenon when the soil, as a result of intense earthquake shaking, turns into a fluid state. Now that usually results in really large ground deformations that could cause damage to any type of structure that is founded on these type of soils. Now this is particularly important for Portland, where we sit at the confluence of two major rivers, Willamette and Columbia. And the soil deposits from these two major rivers are known to be notorious for liquefaction. In addition to that, we are also expected to get hit by the Cascadia subduction zone earthquake, which is going to have induced really large shaking over a really long duration, by some estimates up to 2 to 4 minutes of strong shaking. These two combined are recipes for soil liquefaction and disastrous consequences on our infrastructure. One of the recent interesting projects that we've been working on is on trying to use this method called bioremediation to mitigate liquefaction. It's a novel approach that uses the existing microorganisms in the soil. We feed them with these nutrients, and as a result of the metabolism of these microorganisms, they create these tiny gas bubbles that desaturate the soil. And the idea is that these gas bubbles can act as air cushions or airbags that could absorb the energy from earthquakes and hopefully prevent liquefaction. What makes me excited about this research is that if it's proved to be reliable, it'll be a game changer in liquefaction mitigation. It'll provide a solution, a much cheaper solution compared to other existing methods, to mitigate liquefaction for soils that are underneath the fuel tanks in the Northwest and also other infrastructure in Oregon. My name is Arash Khosravifar, and my research focus is on reducing earthquake risk on our infrastructure and lifelines in order to improve Oregon's resiliency in an aftermath of an earthquake.